How do I encrypt a file? Everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Sending an encrypted document as an attachment is actually a pretty reasonable way to send secure information securely in what is otherwise an insecure medium, email. Even though there are approaches to encrypting email, they're either obscure or complex, or both. And really just not as ubiquitous as we'd like. Encrypting individual files can also be an important step in your own secure data management. I have a specific recommendation that should be easy and work just about everywhere, including cross-platform. The zip file format, formerly referred to as an archive format, lets you bundle multiple files together into a single file that is compressed to save space. Password protecting a zip file encrypts its contents. Now, there's also nothing that says you have to put several files into your zip. As a result, zip is a fine format for encrypting single files. I'm going to use 7-zip as my example, but the zip file format itself is ubiquitous and zipping tools are available on almost every platform, including Windows, Mac, and Linux. You should be able to decrypt a zip file encrypted on one platform on any of the others, even if it has a password. So, let's have a look at 7-Zip. This is the 7-Zip website from which I have downloaded and installed it already. Here's the download link. You can just run that. All right, with it installed, the easiest way I find to run 7-Zip is to hit the start menu and type the number 7. There's nothing else that starts with 7. And there it is, the 7-Zip file manager. Now, we now need to navigate to the folder that contains the file I want to encrypt. In this case, it's in my documents folder, so I'll double-click on that. I'm going to use this BitLocker recovery key as my example. What we do is we right-click on it, click on 7-Zip, and then add to archive. We want to make sure that the archive format is zip. We enter a password. Mine is short. Yours should be long. And we also want to make sure that the encryption method is zip crypto. What I've discovered is that Windows understands zip crypto, but it doesn't necessarily understand AES 256. If you are encrypting and decrypting yourself using only 7-Zip, go ahead and use AES 256. You may even consider using 7-Zip's native format, .7z. But if you are planning to exchange this file with someone else and you don't know what technologies they have, then the right thing to do is to use a zip archive format and the zip crypto encryption method. You can change the file name if you want to. I've simply elected to leave it the same. It's automatically replaced the .txt extension with the .zip extension because we're creating a zip file. Click on OK, and boom, we have an encrypted zip file. You can now send that file to other people, and they can use whatever zipping program they happen to have to extract the contents of that file. Be sure to share the passphrase separately, ideally via a method other than email in this case. I'm going to go ahead and close 7-Zip. I'm going to open up Windows File Explorer. In my Documents folder, you can see that we have both of these files. If I double-click on the zip file, in fact, it's showing me the contents of the zip file. It's showing me the names of the files that are inside of the zip. But more importantly, you can see that this column here that says password protected says yes. What I'm going to do is copy that file and to go over to just another folder that I've created elsewhere on my machine and paste it. It's password protected. This is where Windows asks you for the password. And there's the file, the unencrypted file. So, as we've seen, we were able to create a password-protected zip of a single file using 7-Zip. Then, that file could be examined and unencrypted using Windows itself. Why couldn't we use Windows to encrypt the file? Because for whatever reason, right now, Windows File Explorer doesn't support encrypting files. It supports decrypting them, but not encrypting them, which is why I tend to recommend using 7-Zip or some other tool to actually create your password-protected zip. Now, this has all been using 7-Zip in Windows. If you're interested in using 7-Zip on the command line, I'm actually going to point you at the companion article for this video because it shows you the command line that would be used in 7-Zip to do exactly the same thing. That's at askleo.com/6139. Now, one of the things we saw was that even when encrypted, we could still see the names of the files contained within the zip archive. That may or may not be something you care about. The traditional solution is then to either rename the file to something obscure before you zip it, or zip it twice. Zip it twice has the added benefit of preserving the original file name for the intended recipient. You would zip the file once, without a password, into a single zip file, with an appropriately obscure name, I suppose, zippedfiles.zip. Now, you can zip that file into another zip file, this time specifying an encryption password. That way, both the contents of the files, as well as the names of the files contained within the original zip, are protected. Now, there's often a lot of discussion about what encryption technology is the best and least susceptible to hacking. It's an important discussion, and I believe the scenarios above are sufficiently secure for all but the most demanding applications. However, honestly, hackers rarely gain access to encrypted files by cracking the algorithm. Instead, they simply hack the password. Picking a weak password makes that kind of discovery really easy. Unlike hacking passwords online, in this case, the attacker can spend as much time with your encrypted file as they would like to. In fact, they can throw as much computational power as they might want to simply perform a brute force attack trying every possible password. An eight-character password is nothing to an offline brute force attack. That's why most of these programs don't use the word password, but use the word passphrase. Rather than using a short 8-character password, instead use a longer phrase comprised of 4 or 5 words that total at least 20 characters or more. No matter how you do the math, this is virtually uncrackable using current brute force techniques. Bottom line here is that encryption is an important tool to keep your data secure. Particularly when you're exchanging files with others, single-file encrypting using your favorite zipping tool is a fast and very convenient approach. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/6139. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.